a motor boat heads upstream a distance of 24 km in a river whose current is running at 3 km per hour. The trip up and back takes 6 hours, assuming that the motor boat maintained at a constant speed. What was its speed in still water? So it is given here that the motor boat heads upstream a distance of 20 km in a river whose current is running at 3 km per hour. The trip up and trip back takes 6 hours. So we need to find the speed of the boat in still water. So let us consider the speed of the boat is x km per hour. So since the river is running at 3 km per hour, the speed of the boat in the upstream will be x minus 3 km per hour, and downstream will be x plus 3 km per hour. Now it is given that the trip up and trip back takes 6 hours. So the boat takes 6 hours to go up and come back in the current. So since we know that the formula for time is distance by speed, so here the distance is 24 km. So 24 divided by x plus 3 plus 24 divided by x minus 3. Here the sum of up time taken for the upstream and the downstream. So time taken for to travel 24 kilometers with the speed of x plus 3 plus time taken to travel 24 kilometers with the speed of x minus 3 is given as 6 hours. So 24 by x plus 3 plus 24 by x minus 3 is equals to 6. So we can take 24 common in the numerator of these two fractions. So 24 into 1 by x plus 3 plus 1 by x minus 3 is equals to 6. Now transposing this 24 on the other side, that will be 6 by 24. So 6 1 times, 6 4 times. Now here also we can cross multiply. X minus 3 into 1 is x minus 3, and x plus 3 into 1 is x plus 3 divided by, in the denominator we will get x plus 3 into x minus 3. Now from the numerator we can cancel minus 3 and minus 3, and here we can cancel 6 1 times, 6 4 times. So here x plus x is remained, and in the denominator we have x plus 3 into x minus 3, which is in the form of a plus b into a minus b, which is equals to a square minus b square. Here a square is x square and b square is 3 square, which is 9. So x square minus 3 square, which is equals to x square minus 9. So we have x plus x 2x by x square minus 9 is equals to 1 by 4. Now cross multiplying here, 4 into 2x is 8x, and 1 into x square minus 9 is x square minus 9. So 8x is equal to x square minus 9. Transposing this 8x on the other side, that will be x square minus 8x minus 9 is equals to 0. Now this is a quadratic equation, and it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. We need to find the value of x by finding the roots of the quadratic equation using factorization method. By splitting the middle term, we can find. So for splitting the middle term, we have to find any two numbers whose sum is equals to the middle term, which is minus 8, and the product is equals to the coefficient of x square and the constant term. Here we have coefficient of x square 1 and the constant is minus 9. So we have to find any two numbers whose sum is equals to minus 8 and the product is equals to minus 9. So let us consider the products of the pairs of numbers whose product is equals to 9. So it means the factors of 9. So we have 1 and 9 whose product is 9, and 3 and 3 whose product is 9. So in these two pairs we can take 1 and 9, because minus 9 plus 1 can be written as minus 8. So minus 9 plus 1 is equals to minus 8 when it is summed up, and if we multiply minus 9 into 1, the product will be minus 9. So this is the perfect combination. So we can take minus 9 and minus 9 and plus 1 to replace minus 8. So the middle term minus 8x can be written as minus 9x minus 1. So x square minus 9x plus 1 minus 9 is equals to 0. From the first two terms we can take x common, and the last two terms there is nothing common, so we can take 1 common. So if we take x common, here x is remained and minus 9 is remained, and the last two terms if we take 1 common, x and minus 9 is remained. Now in these two terms, x into x minus 9 and 1 into x minus 9, we have x minus 9 common. So here x is remained and plus 1 is remained. Now if we equate x minus 9 is equals to 0, x will be plus 9, and if we equate x plus 1 is equals to 0, x will be minus 1. Since the speed x cannot be negative, we can take x is equals to 9. Therefore, the speed of the boat in the still water is x is equals to 9 km per hour.